I'm on a quest to find the best thrift store in America.
And guess where we are this week?
No.
Las Vegas, famous for Channing Tatum lookalikes, ugly carpets, and slow, slow walkers.
Over the next 2 days that I'm here, my mission of utmost importance will be to find the best thrift store in all of Las Vegas, Nevada.
This is the hometown of some professional thrifters, the art of resale, American arbitrage, lady arbitrage. I'm reaching out to them to see where they think I should go.
Stick with me to the end, where we'll give a report card to every thrift store that I go to.
My first stop here in Nevada is at Castaways Resale.
I looked on Reddit for the best thrift store in Vegas. 10 people thumbs up Castaways here in Henderson.
Well, is this our first piece of local memorabilia we found? Check out the Raiders foam finger. Oh my goodness.
Nobody wants a roundhouse kick to the face when you're wearing these bad boys.
Do you think I got where I am today because I dress like Peter Pan here? Take a look at what I'm wearing, people.
A sweet pink golf bag, but they got it marked for 30 bucks. Really good shape. This thing would go for like 100 bucks on eBay.
Since I did fly here, I can't buy stuff as big as golf bags because there's no way for me to get it home unless I want to ship it, which is really expensive. What I thought about doing was taking it to a place called Play It Again Sports where I can sell it to them and then they can give me a like 50% of what it's worth. The only Play It Again Sports in Vegas is closed. I did find a place called Play It Again Sam's, but we're in Las Vegas and that's basically a strip club, so no deals for the golf bag today.
This place passes the vibe check. It's really cool. Prices are solid, well organized. From a YouTube channel.
Oh, are you?
Yeah.
To do like thrifting stuff.
Uh-huh.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I'm from Utah. I've been like flying around and trying to find the best thrift store in the country.
Ah, cool.
Yeah.
That's cool, man.
And this one's got a lot of likes on Reddit, so.
Yeah, well, we have a little mission behind it. This actually helps support inmates and their families. Maybe that'll help your decision.
For every like the videos in this series get, we're donating a penny to the winning thrift store's charity.
Almost no guys go, that's gonna factor in the decision a little bit. These are kinda cool.
Whoa, no way!
Did you see this? This is Bob Ross grilled cheese.
This is brand new.
That's a great item. What is it, $4?
$5.97.
$6 for a Bob Ross grilled cheese maker.
Come
that's
on,
a keeper.
That is amazing.
Good crack.
You got a big bug to pick?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Do you know how much these are?
$4.97. Oh yeah?
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Castaways is the first one, but they're off to an early lead. I have three criteria for what makes a great thrift store. And number one is the quality of items. Number two is the amount of those items. And number three, you can't have a great thrift store without good vibes. Now for our Las Vegas checklist, I'd love to find something like Siegfried and Roy, something from one of the concert venues that have been here. But I also am a big fan of food, and I've been watching celebrity chef Bobby Flay most of my life. We have to go to his restaurant, Side Caesar's Palace.
Next stop right here.
We're at the Goodwill in Henderson, Nevada.
Looks like a nice one. See some Yeezys in the case.
Hi, is there anything you need to see in here?
Yeah, can I see the white shoes?
I'll show you all. There, I guess.
$120. Do you know how long these have been in the case?
Oh, yeah, not that long. Less than a week.
It's just scary to spend that much when I don't know if they're real or not.
Right.
Thank you.
Exactly.
All right, well, I feel like this is gonna be a trend for Goodwills no matter where I go, all over the country. They are just barbaric. I'm gonna wait to do my reviews at the end, but this one is getting a low grade.
We have three different thrift stores all within a few blocks. Thanks to a note from one of my friends on Reddit. This one is the Salvation Army. Let's get it.
Smells a little funky in here, not gonna lie.
This PGA Championship cooler is an interesting find. There's no way this is fitting a checked bag. Probably worth about 50 bucks.
Oh wow.
some terrible things about White Castle. I've tried the frozen little sliders from White Castle, like at the grocery store, and they were nasty. Everyone else tells me to stay away from it. Am I wrong?
Store number 4 on the first day in Vegas.
Did I step on that? Oh, my bad. Oh, there's a Furby. Where was that when I was in Atlanta? 25 for the Furby boom. Do we have some docks here? Fake.
Found a pair of Nike Air Huaraches. $18. These go for like $55 or $60. $30 profit. Filling up this much in my suitcase. It's just not quite good enough.
I have a YouTube channel.
Oh, nice. That's cool. Just kind of like for like deals, like that kind of stuff?
Yeah. Right now I'm doing like a thing where I'm going around the country trying to find the best thrift store in America.
Oh, what? Yeah. Really? That's cool. Wait, so where are you from?
From Utah.
Oh, nice. What has the best right now?
Utah's been the best, actually.
Really? That's funny.
And I don't know if it's because like I just know that area better and I like have a better understanding of like what to find there, but I don't know. Where's your favorite place to go?
I just go to the basics. You know what I mean? What's close?
In this area?
Yeah, like in this area.
I just went to Castaway, Goodwill.
Yeah, Castaway sucks.
Thanks.
Well, yeah, I just had to ask.
Yeah, no worries.
Have a good one.
You too.
We're going to try some on the other end of the area. I slid into the DMs of American Arbitrage and Lady Arbitrage, and they both told me that the Deseret Industries in their area are the best. I also reached out to the Art of Resell, but he left me on red, so he's dead to me.
Right, Deseret Industries in Utah was one of my favorite picks. This is the first one in Vegas. We'll see how it goes.
Oh, we had a Jurassic Park dinosaur here. It's a little broken, or I would pick this up. One of my most popular TikToks talks about this. You look for the Jurassic Park, Jurassic World logo on the foot. This thing's only $3. Goes for about 30. Look at this guy. He looks like he's seen something in his life.
It's the yard area.
The vibe in here is kind of nice. The inventory though, not great. There's another solid golf bag. $30. This is probably a booty, but it's a Kanye West jersey. Yeah, I mean like the threading right here does not look good. Going for $20 new, so that's a no. Oh wait, this shirt's pretty cool. This has gotta be at least from the 2000s. Crazy hit on the back. Oh, we're getting that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Almost done with day one of our thrift store adventure here in Las Vegas. This is Opportunity Village.
This store was recommended by Ready, Set, Resell.
Oh, sure.
The only reason I brought my backpack was to clip it on to the GoPro. That's wild.
Got a Bob Ross Chia pet. For 15, sheesh. It's like the Walmart price.
I'm doing this strictly for the love of the thrift. If I was trying to make a bunch of money today, I would be going bankrupt. I fly out strictly to these places for the vibes, for the fun treasure hunting adventure.
So far, it's just been a little dry here in Nevada.
Ben, I think his name is, from Ready, Set, Resell. He walked out of this place after being in there for maybe a half hour with all kinds of Lululemon. He had some steals, but me, not so much. So people come to Vegas for the food of Wolfgang Puck or Gordon Ramsay. I just come right here.
This is what we have here. This is the Crunch Burger. Potato chips on the burger. We got the fries and we got the dark chocolate shake.
Burger's a solid 8. The fries and the sauce get a 9 out of 10 and the shake gets a 9 out of 10. Go to Bobby's Burgers, you're not gonna regret that. New day, a new opportunity here in Vegas. We're at another Deseret Industries. This is the one that American Arbitrage recommended to me as the best thrift store in Vegas.
About a minute before they open, the line is formed.
come to the case. Some $20 bags of jewelry. I forget most of the time. It's still early in the morning. I got my lucky UNLV shirt on. We are going to another one before they open, and hopefully we can find something a little bit better. The spot opens in just a few minutes. It's called Assistance League. I saw this on a YouTube video by a YouTuber named Rochelle Spire.
Oh, the
Rosie O'Doll. Pretty, pretty. 18. Off to a very, very pricey start.
Did she say,
okay, is this on sale? It's great. Half price. Half price. Very nice thrift store, almost like a boutique. A little too expensive. A lot too expensive in a lot of ways. Some of the nicest ladies in there. So sweet. But again, nothing I'm looking for. I was a little hasty about White Castle, and I expect to be roasted for what I'm about to do next. Can I do Jack's spicy chicken sando?
Okay. There you go. Thank you. Give me a minute.
I realize I've shown more of my food adventures on this trip than I did the entire rental car and hotel. Like I stayed at the Stratosphere last night for like $20. Didn't even talk about it. Renting a hotel for like $20 was the most thrifty thing that I've done on this trip so far. This place is the second highest recommended on Reddit. There's that thrift store smell. I love these little TVs, so small.
Hi, how are you?
Nice, good. Have
you been here before?
No.
Well, can I tell you about us?
Please.
What's your name?
I'm Tyson.
Tyson, I'm Gina.
Hi, Gina.
What part of Utah?
Salt Lake.
I was just there.
Oh, cool.
We are a nonprofit, and all these are donations, and the proceeds go to a Home for Spot Dog Rescue, truly. And it goes to the medical and dental of our rescue dogs to get them ready for their forever home. And today is a great day because most things are 50% off.
I'm excited. Thanks. Thank you.
Hey, how are you doing?
Good. Did you know today is 50% off?
Yeah.
Most things. Oh, good. Oh, next one.
I had high hopes for that. What's happening? Side patio. She was the sweetest. Thought these were Legos for $2. I got excited. Bummer. I'm walking out empty-handed, and you might think that that means that this place gets a bad score, but that's not true. The place was cool to look at, good vibes. I feel like today might be an off day. Dog Junkie is one of my favorites in Vegas. Going into a Savers that no one recommended. Oh, maybe we're not. Emergency exit only. Bins of new shoes. Jordan cleats. Is it okay if I look through these?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I never would have expected that these were worth this much. Just gotta find the other one now. Oh, there it is, thank you. Here is a single stitch Winnie the Pooh for $3. We're getting somewhere. I always look for different special edition Monopolies, and this is an Elvis, and it is $3.50. Only selling for about $25 though, unfortunately. Some of these can go for like $100. And there's the Fortnite one, and this one goes for even less, so. So this is easily the most profitable stop in Vegas so far, but the Savers, or any Savers in general, they just don't have great vibes.
Oh my
exactly what I was waiting to buy.
Good news is I'm gonna make some money on these shoes. I only spent $13.50. The bad news is they're not gonna fit into my bag. They are a size 13 and that is 2.5 sizes too big. This is a spot that absolutely no one recommended. It's next to one of the state liquor stores called Nikki's Treasure Hunt. Morning. Okay. Nikki must have had a hard night. I had this idea to do this review at the newest feature in Vegas.
This is so big, it's like an eclipse right now. Let's review the thrift stores of Las Vegas. First stop of the trip was Castaways. Castaways was fun to check out. I got some cool sunglasses. I got the Raiders foam finger. I also got some shorts, and those ended up being really tight. So, no go on the shorts. Although I only found a couple of things there, I think Castaways ranks up high. You know what? I'm gonna do the rest of this review at the airport because this is starting to look a little bit like a rap video. It was a much better idea in my head. Flying Frontier on my Go Wild pass. I made some money from my garage sale, enough to fly anywhere I want for the next 5-6 months for $300. Each flight, I only have to pay for the taxes. The only little problem with that is Frontier nickels and dimes you for everything else, including baggage. So I gotta be selective with what I buy. So I'm wearing the golf shoes home. Since we made so many stops, I'll give full report cards to the more notable stores and just a quick grade to the others. First and only Goodwill stop. The more I see these different types of Goodwills, the less I really like. They just have this stark Ross wannabe kind of vibe, and I'm not in favor. The Salvation Army had a better vibe than Goodwill. They ultimately had a couple of cool items, but not really a great variety. First Savers had your typical Savers type vibes. They had that trash pair of focus, but other than that, not really that great. Ice cold, dare I say. I did meet that nice girl there who said that that store was actually pretty good. Could have been an off day when we were visiting. The first DI we stopped at yesterday, it was fine. I like my thrift stores to have a little bit of pizzazz, spunk, joie de vivre. Those dinosaurs I found are always gonna be a good reseller. They can go for around $20 to $30. That vintage Steelers tee that I picked up there is a great find, the best thing that we got there, the only thing that we got there. And it should sell for about $25. If there were opportunities at Opportunity Village, they were squandered. We found nothing there, the vibes, mid-tier. If you have a better word for vibes, let me know, because I don't know if it like hits the nail on the head. That place made me check my backpack, which I can understand, but I absolutely didn't like. And if you don't think I'm petty enough to let that affect the score, you're wrong. Moving on to our second Deseret Industry. This is the first place that we went today. Right when they opened, no excuses. They should have some good finds, but they did not. I do trust that the arbitrages have pulled out some great items from this specific store. It was not in the Vegas cards for me today. Dog Junkies, although I didn't find anything there today, great vibes, great people. Gina was an absolute gem. I love a thrift store with a solid mission. They get added points for that, as well as Castaways. This thrift store is ranked really high on Reddit, so I have a feeling if I was more of a regular there, then I'd find some great stuff. Now, if we were to judge the winner solely based on the outcome of what I found at this one Savers, then this thrift store would have won the best in Las Vegas. But that is not how I grade. With Savers, they're primarily a for-profit company, so I like them less. And not only do they make profit on what they get for free, but they overcharge massively. And that affects the vibe, my friends. But I will throw out some points for the vintage Winnie the Pooh tee and the Michael Jordan golf shoes. The tee should get like $25 and these shoes could go for at least $200. Nikki's Treasure Hunt, I guess we'll never know. All that being said, I think Utah still has first place. The Crossroads Thrift Store in Salt Lake City is my number one so far. If you had fun on this Vegas thrift trip with me, make sure and subscribe to find out where we go next.